করি, কান খেয়েছ তোর, কান খেয়েছ, কান খেয়েছ তোর, হট চলো ফুটে আসে, কান খেয়েছ গো তোর, কান খেয়েছ, কান খেয়েছ, কান খেয়েছ তোর, কান খেয়েছ, কান খেয়েছ তোর, জি কান খেয়েছ, কে করি, কে করি, ম্যাচ পড়ে দিবি, চলো হটে আসে, চলো হোক হতো, চলো হটো হটো আসে, চলো হটো না আসে, হট চকরি চকরি, আঁখে কেউ বন্ধ করি, আঁখে আঁখে বন্ধ করি, হট 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 হট, মারুম মর দুঙ্গা, উসকে মে মর দুঙ্গা, চল হট হটে আসে, কাম করে আমি মার দুঙ্গা, পকড়ো বহু টাইম ওয়েস্ট করি তুমি, চলো হটো হটো, হটিনি রে, হটতি কেউ নিও, হটো হটে হট হটে আস, চলো হটো চলো ভোগো, চলো ভোগো, স্কেল সে মর, স্কেল সে মর, চল 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 চলো, হে কে হো রা, ইয়ে কে হো রা, হ্যাঁ ক্যা কর, চলো ইয়ে লেট ইট হোগি, হ্যাঁ ইয়ে লেট হোগি, ইয়ে ইয়ে কে হো রা, ইয়ে কে, ये क्या करे, ये क्या हो रहा है, नहीं जाओगे, हैं चले काम करने के लिए कह रहा हूँ, यही लटी रही है ऐसे।
तो फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 13 आल्सो दे हैव नॉट गिवन द फिगर, okay, so you have to imagine, you have to think that how you can draw the figure from whatever information has been given in the question, you should draw the, you should be able to draw the figure. Without drawing a figure you cannot solve, okay. So now what they are saying, the statement of the question is that P is the midpoint of arc APB of a circle, so because dimensions are not given, you can draw any circle, okay. So with the help of the compass you should draw it on the paper, okay, then only if you do it yourself then only you will understand it. Maths is about doing. If you are simply watching the video without participating from your side, then you cannot understand, okay. So open the compass of any width because it has not been given and draw a circle. So because you are drawing a circle, so you must be knowing where the center is. So let us imagine that center is somewhere here. This is point O. Now P is the midpoint of arc APB. Again, length is not given, so you can keep, you can consider any point on the circumference. Let us say you are considering this point. Keep the compass here and you want midpoint of arc APB. P is the midpoint, so you can take compass of any width, once cut the circumference like this and then without changing the width of the compass, keep the needle here and again cut it like this. So now this will be the midpoint, okay. So this is P, this is point A, arc is APB, so I am taking AP and this point I am labeling B. Now you join A with B. So this is your chord you are getting. Next they are saying we have to prove that tangent drawn at P will be parallel to the chord. Chord means AB, tangent drawn at point P. So again you should know how to draw a tangent at a point P. So you can make use of the property. The tangent will be perpendicular to the radius. So if you draw a line like this OP and then at point P you have to draw a perpendicular. You should know with the help of compass how to draw. I have explained to you previously, I mean in question number 12 I have given the explanation, and previously I have also uploaded a video in which I have explained to you the proof of the Pythagoras theorem. There also I have explained to you a number of constructions. So keep the needle of the compass at point P, draw an arc like this, I mean like this, okay. Without changing the width of the compass, keep the needle here, cut the previous arc like this, then again cut the previous arc like this, then without changing the width of the compass, draw an arc on this side. You have to keep the needle at this point, similarly keep the needle at this point and draw it like this. So it should be if you do it, you will be getting a point from where, if you join this P, you will be getting a 90 degree angle. So this will be tangent. Now if you extend it, you will be getting a line like this. So that's how you have to draw the figure, okay. So that is what they are saying. You are having a circle, P is the midpoint. You are having a chord AB, a tangent at P. Now you have to prove that tangent at P, that is this tangent, is parallel to the chord AB. Okay. So that is how. Now let us have to draw the figure. Now let me rub all these arcs. So let us join the points A with P. Why not? Let us join P with B. Okay. Yes. So this angle. Now let me call this point Q. Let me call this point R. So this angle APQ. Now this is the angle between, you can see, tangent and a chord. So this will be equal to the angle in the alternate segment. So AP is the arc, it is appending an angle like this. So these two angles will be equal. Okay, but you know that P is the midpoint. So AP, this distance will be equal to the PB. Isn't it? AP will be equal to PB, because P is the midpoint of the arc AB. So A to P will be same as P to B. That means triangle APB will be isosceles. This angle will be equal to this angle. Isn't it? Triangle APB will be isosceles, because distance from A to P must be equal to distance from P to B. That means you want to say that angle QPA will be equal to the angle PBA. The angle between tangent and chord will be equal to the angle in the alternate segment like this, and angle PBA will be equal to angle PAB. So if angle QPA is equal to angle PAB, then you can see a Z formation here like this. Alternate interior angles are equal. This angle is equal to this angle. If alternate interior angles are equal, it means that AB and this tangent QR, they are parallel to each other. Then if you draw this AP as the transversal, then this angle, alternate interior angles will be equal. Like this way you can prove that tangent drawn at P will be parallel to the chord. Okay, so you can see that two circles are intersecting. MN is the common chord. Okay, and this AB is a common tangent. Now MN, when extended, it is intersecting at the point P. So we have to prove that this MN extended, I mean when produced, it will bisect the common tangent AB. That is, you have to prove that AP will be equal to PB. Okay, so you have learnt about the theorems of the tangent and chord. Okay, if P is the point of intersection for the larger circle, I am saying AP is the tangent. So AP square, it will be equal to PM into PN, where P is the point of intersection. Now the same theorem apply for the smaller circle. P is the point of intersection, so PM into PN for the smaller circle, PM into PN, it will be equal to the square of the tangent. Tangent is PB, it will be equal to PB square. So if you compare these two equations, you can say that AP square is equal to PB square. In other words, you can say that AP is equal to PB. Like this, you can say that the common tangent AB is bisected by the point P. Like this you can do. So in this figure has been given the question. Angle DCQ is indicated 40 degree and angle this ABD is 60 degree. So you can see QP is a tangent at the point C, DB is the diameter. Okay, so now you can see that if QC is the tangent and DC is the chord, then this angle will be equal to the angle in the alternate segment. So DC is subtending angle here at B, this angle. So straight away you can write that angle DBC will be 40 degree. This angle will be 40 degree. Okay, so angle DBC, first part, will be equal to 40 degrees. So this will be 40. Now you know that BD is the diameter. Angle in the semicircle is 90 degree. This diameter will subtend here an angle 90 degree. So use the angle sum property for the triangle DBC. 90 degrees and 40, 130. So this angle will be 50 degrees, isn't it? Now see here, CP is the tangent, BC is the chord. So this angle will be equal to the angle subtended by BC in the alternate segment. That is this angle. This BC is subtending angle over here. You can see 50 degrees. Okay. So this is 50 degree. It means that this angle, second part of the problem, angle BCP will also be 50 degree. Now you know that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. So opposite angles will be supplementary. That is angle ABC 60 plus 40 is 100 degrees plus this angle ADB plus this angle BDC, that is 50 degrees. Their sum will be equal to 180 degrees. Opposite angles will be supplementary. Three angles you know, 60, 40, 50. So what will be this remaining angle? 60 and 40, 100, 100 and 150. So remaining angle will be, this angle will be 30 degree, isn't it? Then only it can be supplementary. 50 and 30, 80 and 40, 120 and 60, 180. So third part, your angle ADB will be 30 degree. Like this you can do. Okay? Figure has been given. Question number 16. We have to prove that angle ACD plus angle BAC is equal to 90 degree. So what you can do is, you can join this point here with the point C like this. So let me call this point here. Let me call this point as M. Okay. So now because center has been indicated, it means that AM is diameter. If AM is diameter, so angle in a semicircle is 90 degree. Angle subtended by the diameter on the circumference. So this angle will be 90 degree. Okay. So now you can see that AC is the tangent. AC is the chord and CD is the tangent. So angle between the tangent and the chord, this will be equal to angle in the alternate segment. AC, I am talking of the arc AC. So it is subtending an angle like this here. So these two angles will be equal. Okay. So that means angle ACD, this angle will be equal to angle AMC. Now look at the triangle MAC. You can use the angle sum property. This angle is 90 degree. That means sum of this angle plus this angle must be 90 degree. That is angle CMA plus angle MAC will be 90 degrees, isn't it? This angle plus this angle should be 90 degree. But this angle, that is angle CMA, is equal to the angle ACD. So you can substitute the value here. You can write angle ACD plus angle MAC. MAC is same as BAC. So here instead of MAC, you can write angle BAC. This will be equal to 90 degree. This only we had to prove. Okay, like this you can do. So you are having a right triangle ABC, right angle at B. Now taking BC as diameter, so let us say the center is O. Okay, so taking BC as the diameter, they have drawn a circle which is intersecting the hypotenuse at D. This is 90 degree angle, so opposite side AC will be hypotenuse. So the circle is intersecting the hypotenuse at D. Then we have to prove that AC into AD is equal to AB square. So what you can do is that you can join the points B and D like this. You can see that BC is the diameter. Angle subtended in a semicircle is right angle. Okay. So this angle in a semicircle, this will be 90 degree. This diameter will subtend angle 90 degree. Okay. So now what you can do is you can consider two triangles, triangle A, B, D, and if you consider the triangle A, B. Okay. So this triangle, I am saying triangle A, B, D, and if you compare it with triangle A, C, B, then you can see that in both the triangle, this angle is common. So you can say that angle, this angle D, A, B, angle D, A, B, it is equal to the angle BAC, isn't it? Because these two angles are common. Then you can also say that this angle, This angle will be 90 degree. So angle ADB, angle ADB, it will be equal to angle ABC. Both angles are 90 degree. ABC is also 90 degree and ADB is also 90 degree. Hence you can say that by AA rule these are similar. By AA rule. Now whenever you are writing about the similar triangles, now it is very important to write the corresponding vertices. Okay, you should be very clear about this. In case you are writing it ABC, then subsequently it will be difficult. I mean, because that is wrong. The angles you have to write in the same order. For example, ADB is equal to ABC. So D of one triangle like this is corresponding with the B of the other triangle like this. And in the first here is the equation, you can see that angles A, they are common. So this A is also corresponding. So whenever you are writing about the similar triangle, because this is a common beginner's mistake. Many times students say that here they will write ADB and here they will write ABC. And then they will say that sir, how these are similar, they are not coming similar. Because you have written them wrong. If you write it ADB and here you write ACB, then that will be wrong. This has to be written in the proper order in which the angles are corresponding to each other. ABD, then this is ACB. Then only it will come. Okay. So now what you will say that if they are similar by AA rule, then what you can write? There the sides, corresponding sides will be proportional. Okay, the sides will be proportional. So you can say that for this AB, first two alphabets you are taking AB. So there also you should take the first two alphabets upon AC. It will be equal to AD. First and third, so here also first and third AB, because you have written them correctly in the correct order. So that is why we can write it like this. So here you can cross multiply. It will be AB square will be equal to AC into AD. Now here let me tell you, if you take BD, then that will also be correct. BD upon BC. But I am not taking this thing. Why I am not taking this thing? Because this is not as per my requirement. I am working. While I am working the problem, I am also keeping eye on my requirement. I do not require BD, I do not require BC. That is why I have not taken this part. Okay. So whatever we require, that only we take. So like this way you can prove that AB square will be equal to AC into AD. So this what we have determined, I am writing here this statement that triangle ABD will be similar to triangle ACB. This we have proved with the help of AA similarity rule. So now similarly you can work for the other triangle BCD, which is also having 190 degree angle. So BCD, now you want to prove it similar to the bigger triangle, then again you must write in the proper sequence the vertices. So angle D, at D point you are having 90 degree. For the bigger one, at B point you are having 90 degree. So D should correspond with B when you are writing. So D should correspond with B. D you are written in the last. So there also write B in the last. Then which angle is common? Angle at C is common. So C you have to write in between. Here you have written in between. So for the bigger triangle also C should write, you should write in between. That means for the bigger triangle you should write in this sequence, triangle ACB. Now you can say that angle BDC. See, when you are writing BDC, so that means you are writing in this sequence at the third alphabet, you are writing at the second position. In the second alphabet, you are writing at the third position. You are writing it like this. So similarly, you have to do here. Shift the second third alphabet to the second position, ABC. Now C also verify from the figure, BDC is 90 degree and ABC is also 90 degree, perfectly alright, because we have written the these vertices in the proper order. This is 90 degree. Then you want to say that this angle DCB or angle BCD, if you want to write angle BCD, it is written in the same order, BCD. So this also have to write in the same order, will be equal to angle ACB. You can see from the figure, BCD is equal to ACB. because these are common angles. This angle is common. So again, you can say that these two triangles are similar by AA rule. Now you see, if you want to write proportionality for here, then you will see that here what is required is BD square. Here you can get BD square, but here you cannot get BD square. So that means directly if you try to write the sides proportional to each other, just as we have done in the first subpart, then it will not be possible because you want BD square. So you must think that BD into BD, that is two triangles in which BD is coming. So you will see that in two triangles, in triangle ABD, you are having BD, and then triangle BCD, you are having BD. That means you should express proportionality when you are taking the sides of ABD and BCD. So how we can say that, how we can take the sides of these two triangles, that you have to think. Meanwhile, this what we have proved, I am writing here that triangle ACB, this triangle is similar to triangle BCD, again by AA rule. Okay, so now what you have to do is see these two statements that we have proved. ABD is similar to ACB and ACB is similar to BCD. So if you compare these two statements, you can say that triangle ABD is similar to triangle BCD, isn't it? Comparing these two statements. Now if ABD is similar to BCD, that solves our problem. How it solves our problem? Because now if we express the sides proportionality, then we can get BD square. So here you can take BD, you are taking last two alphabets, so here also last two alphabet, BD upon CD, it will be equal to, so BD you are having, CD you are having, next you want AD. So AD you have to take first and the third alphabet. So here also take first and the third alphabet, you will get BD. Now if you cross multiply, you can say that BD square will be equal to AD into CD. That only we had to prove. So like this way you can work out this problem. So we have been given that AC is equal to AE. Okay, so AC is equal to AE. And then we have to prove that CP is equal to EP and BP is equal to DP. So AC and AE, they are parts, these are the sides of two triangles. ACP, you can consider here, triangle ACP. And you can consider here AEP. So if you look at this arc BD, it is subtending two angles. One like this and also at the point E. Okay, so both of these angles will be equal because they are subtended by the same arc BD. That means you want to say that these two angles will be equal. That is angle ACP, it will be equal to the angle AEP. Okay, because they are subtended by the same arc BD. Sorry, it will not be ACP, ACD will be the triangle. ACD is one triangle, not P, it will be ACD. And this is one triangle, AEB, not AEP, AEB, like this. So here also it will be angle ACD, it will be equal to angle AEB, like this. So as I was saying that, and this angle will be common, that is the angle CAD. Here if you want to write CAD, you are trying to shift the second alphabet in the first position, so CAD. Here also it will be, you have to shift second alphabet to the first position, EAB, angle EAB. You can check from the figure also, CAD and EAB, they are the same angle because they are common. Okay, this angle is common. So again you can say that, as in the previous question, again we are making use of the similarity rules by AA similarity. So if you can express the, you can use proportionality between the sides AC, first two alphabet, here also first two alphabet you will take AE, AC and AE, this will be equal to AD, first and third alphabet, so here also first and third alphabet AB. Okay, Now you know that AC is equal to AE. That means this two will cancel, you will get 1. If you cross multiply, you will say that AB is equal to AD. AB is equal to AD, and you know that AC is given equal to AE. That means you want to say that BC will be equal to DE, isn't it? Subtracting second from first, AC minus AB. AC minus AB, you will get BC. Okay, so straight away I am writing here BC. Similarly here AE minus AD. AE minus AD, you will get ED. So this is one result that we can use. So here I am writing BC is equal to ED. This we have proved and we will use it. So BC is a part of this triangle BCP. So you can say triangle BCP. And here you can take another triangle DEP. Notice how I am writing the corresponding angles. See here I have written triangle BCP. And I know this angle is corresponding to this angle. So that means corresponding to C, I have written vertex E here. And then here you can see that these two angles are vertically opposite angle. So P and P are coming at the same position. And then left out vertex is B for the first triangle and D for the second triangle. So as I was saying previously, whenever you are trying to make use of similarity, always write corresponding vertices for the two triangles. Then it will be easier for you. I mean, it is the correct way to do it. So now, as I was saying that these two angles are equal with the help of the, you can say that these two are vertically opposite angles. In these two triangles, angle BPC will be equal to angle DPE, vertically opposite angles. Okay. And these two angles are also equal, as we have said before. And also you can see at this arc CE, it is CE if you see, then CE is subtending one angle at B and CE also subtending another angle at D. So these two angles will also be equal. So by AA rule, if two angles are equal, anyway third angle will also be equal. So we can say that they are similar by the AA similarity rule. So if they are similar, then you can say that BC, first two alphabet. So here also first two alphabet DE. Okay, this will be equal to, we have to prove CP EP. So I am taking the second and third alphabet CP. Here also second and third alphabet EP. Now we have proved that BC is equal to ED. So that means we can cancel out. You will get here 1. If you cross multiply, then you can say that CP will be equal to EP. Like this, you can prove the first part. CP is equal to EP. So we can write here this result. CP is equal to EP. Then you have to also prove that BP and DP. Okay. So BP and DP, both you can get here only by this similarity. BP, first and the third alphabet, BP, first and the third alphabet, DP. This will be equal to second and third alphabet, CP, second and third alphabet, EP. We know that CP is equal to EP. So again, this will cancel out. You will get 1 cross multiplying. You will get that BP is equal to DP as required. Okay. So like this, you can prove. So you are having a cyclic pentagon. Circumcircle center is O. Circumcircle means that the circle that is touching all the vertices, its center is indicated O. Now it has been given that AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. Actually, while drawing, this is a freehand drawing. So in this drawing, AB is clearly, I mean, it is smaller than BC. I mean, it is visible. But because it has been given in question, you have to imagine that AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. In fact, if you draw a proper figure, this is not a proper figure with a freehand I have drawn. Okay. So imagine that AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. And this angle has been given ABC as 120 degree. Then we have to find angle BEC. So B is this, E is this. So let us join B with E and C. This angle we have to find. Okay. And we have to find angle BED. So B is this, E is this, and D. So and the whole angle we have to find. These two angles we have to determine. Okay. So you can see here that why not let us join A with C? If you join A with C, then two angles straight away you can say. Now you see triangle BAC is an isos isosceles triangle, isn't it? It is an isosceles. Because it has been given that BC is equal to AB. If AB and BC are equal, it means the triangle BAC is isosceles. And one angle is 120. So, remaining two angles will be equal. This angle will be equal to this angle. So, 180 minus 120, you will get 60. 60 divided by 2 will be 30. So, this angle will be 30, this angle will be 30. You can check for yourself using the angle sum property. 120 plus 120 plus 30 is 150, 150 plus 30 is 180. Now look at this arc BC, it is suspending one angle at the vertex A, it is also suspending angle at the vertex E. So these two angles will be equal. If this angle is 30, this angle will also be 30. So angle BEC, this angle will come out to be 30 degree. So angle BEC will be 30 degree. Now BC is equal to CD. So the angle subtended by BC, CD will be same. In fact, AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. You can see that AB subtending an angle at the vertex C, which is 30 degree. Similarly, BC subtending an angle 30 degree. Okay. So now similarly, BC is also subtending an angle at E. So this is also 30 degree. And similarly, CD subtending an angle at E. So this will also be 30. Because angle subtended by equal arcs will always be equal. You can see that all the angles subtended by AB and BC and CD on the circumference will be equal. So we can say that angle CED will be 30 degree. If this is 30 degree, it solves the question, then the entire angle, that is the whole angle, it will be 30 plus 30, that is 60 degree. So we can say that angle BED, the second part, it will be equal to 60 degree. For the first part, answer will be 30 degree. For the second part, answer will be 60 degree. Okay, so question number 20. You can see that you are having a circle with center at O. AC and BC are the two tangents. Angle ACO is given 30 degrees. We have to find angle BCO. This angle we have to find. And we have to find angle AOB. That is AOB, this angle, and angle APB, this angle. Okay. So if O is the center, you must think that why they are saying specifically that O is the center. So that you can reason out that OB is the radius and BC is the tangent. That means this angle must be 90 degree angle, isn't it? Similarly, OA is the radius and AC is the tangent. So this angle will also be 90 degree. Look carefully at the triangles AOC and the triangle BOC. You will notice that they are congruent. How they are congruent? You can prove them to be congruent by using RHS congruency. 90 degree angle, 90 degree angle. Okay. Side opposite to 90 degree angle will be hypotenuse. So OC is the hypotenuse for triangle AOC. And similarly, OC is also the hypotenuse for the triangle BOC. So that means hypotenuse is equal because hypotenuse is same OC. And one angle is right angle. And then any one side. So which side you can take? You can see here that OA and OB, they are the radii of the same circle. So they will be equal. Hence, both of these triangles, AOC and BOC, they are congruent to each other. If they are congruent to each other, that means you can straight away write that angle BOC will be 30 degrees, isn't it? Sorry, not BOC, BCO will be 30 degree. So first part solution will be 30 degrees. Then see the triangle BCO. You can make use of the angle sum property. That is sum of the all the interior angles will be 180. 90 plus 30, 120. So remaining this angle will be 60 degrees, isn't it? And you know that both the triangles are congruent. So angle AOC, this angle will also be 60 degrees. Okay. Now, what about angle AOB? Angle AOB is equal to angle AOC. plus angle BOC. And both of these angle AOC as well as BOC are 60 degree each. That means together if you add them, then angle AOB will come to be 120 degrees. Okay, so angle AOB will be 120 degrees. Now look at arc AB. It is subtending angle 120 degree at the center. So it will subtend angle of 60 degree at the circumference. Any point on the circumference, okay? At the point P, so this angle will be 1/2 of 120. 1/2 of 120 will be 60 degrees. Like this you can do, okay? Okay, so three circles are drawn touching each other, okay? So A, B, C are the centers. I have drawn with a free end, so this is not exactly coming at the center. But imagine that this is a circle, this is a center B. Now it has been given that AB is 10 cm, BC is 8 cm, AC is 6 cm. We have to find the radii of the three circles. Okay. So let us imagine this BP as X. Then BP and BR, they are the radii of the same circle. So they will be equal X only. Let us imagine this CQ to be Y. Then this CR, this will also be Y. Isn't it? Radii of the same circle. And then let us imagine this AP to be Z. Then AQ will also be Z, radii of the same circle. So now AB is 10. It means X plus Z is 10. BC is 8. That means X plus Y is 8. AC is 6. Y plus Z is 6. So we are having three equations, linear equations. You can solve them easily. Let us label them 1, 2, 3. So what we can do is subtract second from first, 1 minus 2. So X will cancel out, you will get Z minus Y. 10 minus 8 will be 2. You know Y plus Z is 6. You can add, let us call this equation 4. If you perform 3 plus 4, then this Y will cancel out, you will get 2 times Z is equal to 6 plus 2 is 8. So this means that this implies that Z will be equal to 8 divided by 2, that is 4. This is Z actually. Okay, so Z is 4. So I'm rubbing this Z, I'm writing here 4 centimeter, and this will also be 4 centimeter. If Z is 4, then X will be 10 minus Z. 10 minus 4 is 6. So X from here you will get X is equal to 6. So this should be 6. And then X plus Y 8. So Y will be 8 minus X. 8 minus 6 will be 2. So this will be 2. So this was an easy question, but has been asked previously in the board examination. But like this you can easily do it. Okay. Okay, so that's all for today. I think we have taken up roughly 20-21 questions. It has been a long day. That is enough for today. Remaining questions we'll take up in the next video. So my sincere advice will be to all the students to work out the problem yourself. You can take help of the solutions video that we uploaded. Practice the questions by yourself. Please open your notebooks. Okay, on a paper with a pen, solve all the problems. Note down important points. Have a proper notebook. In case you are stuck somewhere, then you can take help of our video solutions. Okay, all the best for your upcoming examinations. It may be pre-board or board examinations. All the best. The remaining question we'll take up in the next video. Please do press like button, share our videos. That is very, very important. Please do write comments in case of any trouble, any question you are not understanding, you are finding difficult. You can WhatsApp me. I'm here to serve you. All the students, as much possible, I try to answer all the queries received same day itself. So you are free to WhatsApp me your doubts. You are free to write comments in whichever way. I can help you out. It will be a great pleasure for me. Okay. Thank you.